Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operation Research. This is lecture number 2.5 in a transportation model. In the early lecture also, we solved a problem in the transportation model. And in this lecture, we'll continue with the transportation model, optimum solution. And here, we are going to take up a problem, which is degenerate type of type. So we'll explain what is degenerate type of problem, and we'll find the optimum solution for a degenerate type of transportation problem. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the transportation model. And we just recall the methodology of calculating optimum solution for transportation model. First, we have to find out the basic feasible solution using the Weigel's approximation method. Then we have to check the number of allocations. They are equal to m plus n minus 1 and are independent. Independent means they should not form a closed loop. All the allocations should not form the closed loop within the matrix. And we have to check for optimality. If it is yes, if the condition for the test is satisfied, then the current basic feasible solution is optimum. So if the condition is not satisfied, then we have to iterate towards the optimum solution using the UV method. So UV method is the mathematical technique developed to find the optimum solution for the transportation model. Then next, using this UV method, we have to find the next basic feasible solution. So once again, we have to check for optimality and we have to satisfy the condition yes or no. Based on that, we have to continue with the problem. We take the example number 7, find the optimum solution for the following transportation problem. The problem has 4 source points and 5 destinations. The source point, they have the supply capacity of 5, 6, 2 and 9. The destination, they have the demand of 4, 4, 6, 2, 4 and 2. The cost matrix is given here and we have to find the solution for the transportation model. So it is a balanced type of problem. The total supply and the total demand are equal to 22. The problem is balanced type of problem. Then we have to find the basic feasible solution using the Weigel's approximation method. And in the Weigel's approximation method, so we have to find the difference between the cell values horizontally and vertically. For every row and every column, we have to find the difference between the least, lowest and the next lowest cell value. For the first row, lowest value is 8. The next lowest value is 11. The difference is 3. For the second row, the lowest value is 5. The next lowest value is 7. The difference is 2. For the third row, the lowest value is 5. The next lowest value is 7. The difference is 2. For the fourth row, the lowest value is 4. The next lowest value is 8. The difference is 4. And similarly, the column, vertical column, for the first column, the lowest value is 8. Next lowest value is 9. The difference is 1. For the second column, the lowest value is 5. The next value is 7. The difference is 2. For the third column, the lowest value is 9, next lowest value is 11, so the difference is 2. Then for the fourth column, the lowest value is 4, the next lowest value is 8, the difference is 4. Then for the fifth column, lowest value is 4, the next lowest value is 5, the difference is 1. For the sixth column, the lowest value is 7, the next lowest value is 12, the difference is 5. Now we have to find out the difference, the maximum difference. The maximum difference is 5 in the sixth column, that we have to make the allocation here. Now for the sixth column, demand capacity is 2 and among the cell values, 4 cell values, the lowest cell value is 7. So for 7, the supply capacity is 6. So all the demands are satisfied. So in the supply capacity of the second row, the balance available is 4. Then the next highest value is 4. So for the fourth column, and again in the fourth column, the lowest cell value is 4. So where the demand requirement is 2. So all the two are satisfied. All these twos are satisfied here. And in the fourth row, the supply capacity 9 is now reduced to 7. The next value is 4. Once again, 4, the third row, fourth row. And here the availability is 7. Whereas here this cell is already allotted. C44 is, X44 is 2 equal to already allotted. The next lowest value is C45 equal to 4. Where the demand is 4, it is completely satisfied. And here the 3 is also supplied here. So horizontally 3 plus 2, 5 plus 4, 9. So it is completely exhausted. S4 is completely exhausted. Here D1, like here 1. The next highest value is 2. So now we can satisfy the 6 is requirement, 5 is supplied here, and 1 is supplied here. So the balance here is 1, the 5 is completely exhausted. Then the next allotment is 2 once again here. So here the lowest value is 4, the demand is 4, and availability is also 4, it is completely satisfied. The next is this 2, where the availability is 1, here we have 1, we require 1. So that is also satisfied. Now these are all the cells allotted. C1, X1, X13 equal to 5, X22 equal to 4, X26 equal to 2, X31 equal to 1, X33 equal to 1, X41 equal to 3, X44 equal to 2, X45 equal to 4. Now the transportation cost. We calculate the transportation cost. C13, X13 plus C22, X22. Plus C23, X23, plus C31, X31, plus C33, X33, plus C41, X41, plus C44, X44, plus C45, X45. Substitute the numerical values. 11 into 15, plus 5 into 4, plus 7 into 2, plus 8 into 1, plus 11 into 1, plus 8 into 3, plus 4 into 2, plus 4 into 4 equal to rupees 156. Now this is degenerated type of problem. So the number of cells allotted should be equal to m plus n minus 1 equal to 4 plus 6 minus 1 equal to 9. But the actual number of cells allotted is 8. So this kind of problem is known as transportation problem with the degeneracy. Now one more allocation is to be made with the infinitesimally small value lambda. So infinitesimally small means very, very small value that makes insignificant effect on the supply or the demand capacity of the matrix. So lambda is very, very minimum of one of the unoccupied least cost cell. The new allocation should be independent. That is, it should not form the closed loop. So we can make the new allocation, but again, this should not form the closed loop. Adding or subtracting any value with the lambda will not affect the value. If more than one allocation is required, you can use lambda 1, lambda 2, etc. So in the present problem, cell 3-2 is selected for lambda. So here, we are allotting cell 3-2. So this is not, this is the lowest cost matrix. So here again we have the lowest cost matrix, but this will form a closed loop. If I look at here, if suppose I make allotment here, this will form a closed loop. So horizontally you move here, here you can take a turn vertically, horizontally, then it will form a closed loop. So the allocation should be on the least cost cell. At the same time, it should not form the closed loop. So the 7 is higher than the 5. But we make the allocation here because it will not form the closed loop. So you look at here, it will not form. The corner of the loop should turn in the allotted cell. That is the condition. When you form your loop, the corner of the loop should form in the, to be in the allotted cell. Now this is the number of allocation now equal to 9. Now we have to check for optimality. So for optimality, first you write the cell values, cost values of the allotted cell. So the 9 cells cost values are written here. You designate the row as U1, U2, U3 and U4. Designate the column as V1, V2, V3, V4 and V5. Now we take V1 equal to 0 and calculate the UV value of all the cell values of unoccupied cell. Now we take V1 equal to 0. So you is taking V1 equal to 0. Now we calculate. First we check this U3 equal to 8. So V1 equal to 0, U3 equal to 8, U4 equal to 8. When U3 equal to 8, so this is 7. So this will become V2 minus 1. V2 becomes minus 1. and this this is again this is 11 and v3 become 3. When v3 become 3, this u1 equal to 8. Then v1 v2 equal to minus 1 and u2 become 6. And similarly, we calculate all the uv values. Once you actually the green color cells, they are the allotted cells, where using the allotted values of the allotted cells, we have to calculate the u1, u2, u3, u4, v2, v3, v4, v5 and v6. Then we have to calculate the values of the unallotted cells. So the white color cells are the unallotted cells. Now this is the first step. Second step, we have to subtract the new value of the unallotted unoccupied cells to the from the original cost matrix. So 11 minus 8, 13 minus 7, 8 minus 4, 11 minus 4, 12 minus 9, 9 minus 6, 9 minus 9, 9 minus 2, 7 minus 2, 13 minus 4, 5 minus 4, 13 minus 9, 12 minus 9, 13 minus 11, 10 minus 7. So 10 is the original cost matrix value and 7 is the new UV value. The again, the green cells are allotted cells. Now, the cell evaluation matrix. So this is called a cell evaluation matrix. All the values in the unoccupied or unallotted cell, they are positive. So the cell evaluation matrix does not possess any negative value. The problem solution of the problem, the previous basic solution is optimum. So the procedure is going to be the same. Now in the degeneracy type of problem, we are making one more allocation. That is the difference. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. So there is one book, Operation Research. You can refer to the book for additional information on the transportation problem. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the transportation model. Until then, bye-bye.